realized the wings was double for the Pope. Then I snatched up a cosign from one of the goats. Come on, vote late again. He may not come when you want, but I'm always up on time. So never for cooking them home when them bills were pile up. Cereal with the water. If Lord couldn't help us, we had hamburger helper when you want. Some people call it ghetto. I prefer another level, but I'm about to board this plane. I can't wait to see your face and hear you say,
come on in, close the door and feel the vibe.
Bro, I don't wanna listen to her, but she don't wanna listen to me. Last week we're talking together forever. This week, more fish in the sea. It's just killing me, G. I had the perfect picture. It was all laid out for.
Thanks for joining us. We're now ready for questions. Okay, thank you. We'll be wrapping up now.
Hi, everybody. A lovely day for football here. Welcome to you. Alan Smith, the former England international, is alongside me, Martin Tyler. And it's the start of the season for both these teams. It's AEK Athens, and they take on Fulham.
Well, so much hope for both clubs before a ball has been kicked. Nobody's made a mistake yet, and as a player, you just want to get off to a good start. Hopefully a winning one.
Line-up for the home side.
Well, it looks like all hands to the defensive pump. At least they've got two forwards.
Yes, and hopefully they will get some service, but it is capable, this shape, of being pretty negative.
Thank you, enjoy the game.
So here we go, we're underway here. Here's Andre Simaric. Neatly intercepted. Anthony Knockhart. Can find some space here on the flanks. Time to get the ball in. Somewhat risky, the defending. That's not what he wanted to do. A poor pass. Goal news for you, and it comes from the Blackburn Rovers game, and it comes from Alan McInally.
It's a goal from...
A great chance to go in front. Push back out into play. Alan McAnally there with a very brief report, a bit briefer than he wanted, I think.
In that game, it was a Blackburn Rovers goal.
And the score is 1-0. He has cleared it well. This is Cissé. Knockout. Cissé. Nothing wrong with the industry of the team. That little bit of inspiration lacking, but they need to get their noses in front. Chance to put it in the box from here. He's gone in wild. Chance now to go ahead. The shot is blocked. He's in now. Well, that's the opener. And it's been coming. The better side. But you have to score when you're on top. We wondered whether they would do that, but they have done. And they've done it in fine style. Fulham have got themselves in front. Anthony Knockout. Slipping it through. Players trying to attack the cross. There's still danger here after this half clearance. Great chance! Comfortable work, really. Bit of a stretch for the goalkeeper, but never looked as though he's going to be beaten.
No, bread and butter, really, for this lad with his talent.
Corner's taken. He's gone in with the header, but the ball nowhere near going into the net.
I think it's come off the top of his head, that one.
Onyen Vranješ. Now, can they move on from this wide area where there is room? To bring them level.
Well, it was a bit desperate, but what a good challenge.
Alan McAnally wants to join us now. He's got a goal to tell us about.
It's a goal for Cardiff City. 32 minutes played. 1-1.
Eagle eyes, as always, from Alan McAnally. This does look promising. Loses possession. On the ball. He could take them on here. Superb individual skill.
Oh, see you later.
Good position for the cross. Well, he's read that, hasn't he? And made the interception, made it look easy, actually. Very good work from the team that's still behind. The forward could be played in. It's a lovely pass. Oh, it's a great goal! Well, there's a goal that's perhaps not gone according to the script here. They just picked their moment to get forward after a lot of defending.
Yeah, and they can thank the defenders for that. But when they did get the ball, they moved it forward really quickly. They were ruthless there.
So away we go at 1-1. And that's the half-time whistle from the referee. 1-1 at the break. I think that's a good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in the first half?
I must admit.
Referee just checking everything is in order, and he blows for the second half to start. Well, let's hear from Alan McAnally, who's got news of a sending off at the game he's watching.
It's a red card for the home team. They're down to 10 men. 46 minutes played. It remains 1-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan. Here they are, still probing away. Now he can cross it.
Deeper cross, back post this time.
He has cleared it well. Marco Livaia. Room now out on the wing.
Golden opportunity now.
Great goal here. And it puts them into the lead.
Well, just not a firm enough touch to keep that ball out, which had a fair bit of weight on it.
Fulham need to re-fortify themselves. At the moment, they are behind.
We can hear about a goal at the Liberty Stadium. Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for Swansea City. 55 minutes played. 2-0.
Eagle eyes, as always, from Alan McAnally. Any thoughts on Fulham's next fixture, Alan?
They're playing Blackburn Rovers in their next match in the Championship. Don't see them having too many problems. Hosts can't quite get hold of the ball. Well, they do say possession is 9/10 of the law, but not the case here. They've used the ball when they've got it really well. They've been so clinical on the counter-attack more often than not.
Well, time is ticking away. It's time for a change, and here it comes.
Le Marchand.
Now they can switch the play here. Quick-witted and quick in his movement too to intercept there. Substitute coming up for the away team. We can go to Alan McAnally now for news of a goal from elsewhere.
It's a third goal for the home team. 63 minutes played, 3-1.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual. Here's André Simard. Let's put you in the picture regarding Paul Pogba and his deal done now. It's confirmed he has completed his move, a huge move to Real Madrid.
Well, this lad is capable of producing the unexpected, something special. And that's why this club have paid around £90 million.
Mitrovic!
He's gone in with the header, but the ball nowhere near going into the net.
I think it's come off the top of his head, that one.
It's a tactical substitution for the losing team here. Mitrovic. Now he could play it into the danger area. Still searching for an equaliser with some good interplay here. Good position for the cross. Goal news for you, and it comes from the Blackburn Rovers game, and it comes from Alan McAnally.
It's a third goal for Blackburn Rovers. 78 minutes played, 3-1.
Well, right on the spot there for that story, Alan McAnally, of course.
Excellent attacking play here. They could open up the opposition now. And he gets it back.
Mitrovic.
Cissé! And the forward could be played in. It was a lovely pass. A really incisive breakaway. Held his position, stayed on side. In at the keeper, but he's denied him.
Oh, he's such a good keeper in these situations. You know, he's very cool, and he got his angles absolutely correct there.
Seven minutes to go. They've worked so hard, the team, to be in front here. And that's been recognised by the supporters.
Yeah, I think they've recognised that it has been a really good performance, but still a bit of work to do.
This could bring them level.
Really good defending. If he hadn't touched it, it was a goal.
Now, one of the keepers thanking him for that bit of closing down by his defender.
Marco Livaia. André Simões.
It looked a set. Well, that's a comfortable save for the keeper from the header.
Well, it's not the most powerful header you'll see this season or even in this match, didn't time it.
Golden opportunity now.
Oh, what a happy goal scorer. He's found the way past the keeper once already, and now he's knocked in his second, and the hat-trick is definitely on for him. Well, it was only a semblance of an opportunity, really, but he's turned it into a great goal with the first-time strike.
I don't think he had a chance, you know, to take another touch. He would have been crowded out, so what a decision.
3-1 the scoreline as we restart the game. Always been called offside here. Attacking team not happy about that offside call, but we can see it again here.
Well, he is quick, this lad, and he can afford to give himself another yard. I think he's got the beating of these defenders in a race.
It's finished now with the final whistle. Well, celebration here. A lot of hard graft has gone into the pre-season, and you hope that that leads to winning the first game, and that's what's happened for them.
Hi, just a couple of questions for you. No further questions.
Threatened like that, you know you're better than average.
Can he add to the goals he scored already this season? He's already the top scorer in the league. What a match. And it's live. Yeah, it's a great day for football in this lovely stadium.
Martin Tyler here with Alan Smith. Our football is from the EFL Championship in England. I think we're both really looking forward to this, Alan.
I love visiting this ground. Rarely been disappointed with the entertainment on offer. Don't think I will be today either.
Let's look at Sheffield Wednesday and the list of their players here. We've got it down as a 4-3-3.
Yeah, it's a system that the Netherlands used to use all the time. I think really they invented it, and plenty of countries have adopted it since. If it works, it's really tough to handle.
Onyen Vranjes. He's one I know Alan's keeping an eye on here.
Two in his previous match. A clear danger man for the opposition.
Let's have a look at how the opposing team will line up today. Well, we put it up, and what looks, Alan, very defensive, but there's flexibility, isn't there, in the side?
Yeah, and I think with his shape, so much depends on the wing-backs, how much they are allowed to get forward and what they can...
Keeper's ball, no question about that. It's a weak cross, really. Trying to slip it through. Opportunity here. Well, it's nowhere near in the end, and he was right in at the goalkeeper.
Yes, one thing missing, but missed by that distance. Bit embarrassing for the lad.
Nelson Oliveira. Interception here. In the Cardiff City match, there's been a goal, and here's Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for the visitors. 18 minutes played, 1-0.
That's Alan McAnally keeping us bang up to date. Delivered into the box. That looked really threatening, but in the end, it was a bit of a damp squib because no one could connect with the cross. Nelson Oliveira. Marco Levi, Andre Simões. Now he wants to take them on.
Could score!
He really gave it the laces there, didn't he, Alan?
Yeah, he did connect with it beautifully. Not a bad effort at all.
Barry Bannon. Luongo. Let's check in with Alan McAnally, who's at Fulham, and there's news of a goal, Alan.
It's a goal for Fulham. 27 minutes played, 1-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan. Could whip it in from here. Good work, really, to read the intention of the pass. Very good tackle. Players trying to attack the cross. It's not really away. Poor clearance. Safety first there. Nelson Oliveira. Maybe took his eye off the ball.
Surely he must score!
Well, that's straightforward for the goalkeeper.
Well, I don't know if they've come into this match with the wrong attitude, but it's not been their true selves today. Not creating anywhere near enough chances, as you can see.
Well, the player's been sent off at Loftus Road. Who it is, we can hear from Alan McAnally.
It's a red card for the visitors. They're down to 10 men. 40 minutes played. It remains 2-0.
Thanks, Alan. And they've spread it out wide here. Well, that's good defending. Well, they couldn't keep possession. They've given it away. Two more minutes to be trying to slip it through. Got to be. An excellent chance. More than matched by the goalkeeper, who's diffused the situation.
Oh, great agility, great reflexes there, and denying the opposition any knockdowns as well.
In goes the corner.
only partially away from danger. Got in the way.
Well, that is half time, and the score is 0-0 here.
Referee just checking everything is in order, and he blows for the second half to start. Dmytro Chigrinsky.
Over at the Riverside Stadium, Alan McAnally is there for us today, incidentally, and he's got a goal to give us the details of.
It's a goal for Middlesbrough, 49 minutes played, 1-1.
That's Alan McAnally keeping us bang up to date.
Harris
taking on the defenders.
What a good chance for the header.
Did well to get ahead of his man, but the header was less than impressive.
That was close and well hit too.
Yeah, he really did get the laces behind it.
Well, the word average comes to mind about his first half. What do you think, Alan?
Yeah, it was hard work for him in that first half. You could see him putting in the shift, but
guided through. Try one now. Well, from that position, so
close. He should have put the ball in the net.
Well, sometimes you can be too close if that's possible. I think it was possible there.
Well, we're two-thirds of the way through the 90 minutes, half an hour to go. Any danger to the goal has gone with that clearance.
Well, let's check in with Alan McAnally here at the Preston North End match. And I believe, Alan, you've got news of a goal.
It's a second goal for the visitors. 62 minutes played, 2-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan.
And in the shot, go! Saved by the keeper. He can't hang on to the ball. Superb save.
He shouldn't have had a chance at all with that. Oh, what about those reflexes? Brilliant.
Corner's taken.
Coming into the penalty area now. He's got the ball under control. He's taking his time.
The home team about to make a change.
Visitors now enjoying more of the possession. Been a good last 15. Now they're looking good with the football that they're playing as well. This is excellent stuff. If they can't get a goal soon to get themselves ahead, they'll be kicking themselves.
Let's check in with Alan McAnally, who's at Fulham, and there's news of a goal, Alan.
It's a second goal for Fulham. 77 minutes played, 2-0.
Well, right on the spot there for that story, Alan McAnally, of course.
Must be a goal! Oh, it's the post! He has cleared it well. That is a tackle and a half. Counting down towards the end of the 90 minutes, 9 minutes left.
Frustrated for these fans at times. They sense the
lovely ball. That's
well timed. Dangerous position. That's a great interception. Striding forward, purposefully. Good football between these two. Nice passing. That's safely away. Trying to catch the player in possession. He's one-on-one with the goalkeeper. That's going to go right to the wire here as they look for a... Surely he must score! Oh, we're still waiting for the game's opening goal. We've had a long wait, but I thought it was going to happen then.
Well, we've seen a few missed opportunities, and that's just one to add to the list here. It's not exactly been clinical finishing out there today.
That's it. Level pegging between the two teams, and it's finished all square. Very enjoyable. It's finished level. Is that about right, Alan?
I think so. Both sides had chances to score more, but I think they'll both be happy with their lot.
Time for a few questions. No further questions.
Got the call in the streets of Seattle. She said, honey, I don't got much time to talk. I broke down because I knew what was next. And she said, I'm okay, but I'm locked in a holding cell till someone gets me out. Can you help me? I have no one else. So there was. Real 70. Dos, tres, agua. Yo sé que hay quien cobra por barrer la calle, por recoger a un ser cuando se desmaye, por ayudar a un impedido con sus barreras y por limpiar la escena del... de tu cena, por arreglar lo que te probaste y no te quedas, por apartar un bloque de la carretera, por limpiar el baño donde tú dejaste hasta la salud de una... Tú no crees más humano alar la cadena, respetarle a otro ciudadano su cera, saber que un impedido no es quien lleva rueda, es cualquiera que se pierde en su mismo sistema. El capitalismo es lindo, pero despega, te llena de excesos que ni te llenan, recibes dos besos que no hacen por uno, qué flaco está tu corazón mientras más come consumo. Ole. We'll be right back.
Sigue creciendo, vamos funcionando sin un orden lógico. Somos animales, la tierra es nuestro zoológico. No conozco a mi vecino porque vive anónimo. Como un sustantivo propio, yo soy su sinónimo. Costumbres capitalistas de un ciudadano. Vender el alma y ignorar a sus hermanos.
Mientras más ganancias tiene,
más retrocedes la costumbre encima del hombro. Pero no puedes comprar amor como un bolso. Con todas tus cuentas de ahorro.
What a perfect day for football we've got here. Alan Smith is alongside me, Martin Tyler. Our football today comes from the Carabao Cup against AEK Athens, against Sheffield Wednesday.
Yeah, some teams are suited to knockout football, others aren't. But we've got a couple of sides here, I think, that will be harbouring ambitions of going all the way in this competition.
And here it is, the starting 11 for the home side today. 4-3-3. And they've got natural wide players in that front three with a central striker.
I think that's the key, because those lads on the flanks, it's quite a complicated job, actually, because they've got to come inside, support the centre forward, and they've also got to funnel back when they haven't got the ball. So an onus on them.
Let's look at Sheffield Wednesday and the list of their players here. Well, we've gone with a 4.
And be adjusted, it could almost be a 4-5-1 if they decide to come over all defensive, this team. But if they're on the front foot, that three up front can cause the opposition back four some problems.
Spotted that well and intercepted. And that ball belongs to the goalkeeper. Here's André Simões. Encouraging play from this team now, keeping the ball. It's given away. And Harris. Another turnover in play here with that interception. He could take them on here. Can go in from here. They've soaked up a lot of danger here, but it hasn't hurt them, and now they're on the ball. Chance for a break in numbers. Just lost their way at the crucial moment of that counter-attack, and they've lost the ball. Now it goes into the wider areas where they've got a winger waiting. Good position for the cross. Well, very easy for the goalkeeper there. Anticipated the direction of the... Excellent movement to get the pass and stay onside. Brilliant goal!
Oh, the crowd appreciating that. And so are his teammates. What a good finish and what a good ball through to him.
Sheffield Wednesday with the lead. Palmer, Barry Bannon, Preston. He's got some room out there.
good safe contact by the goalkeeper to clear it. He's made the interception. Did well, stuck out a foot and cut off the pass. Well, suddenly they could be on the counter-attack. Well, plenty of speed, but not much organisation. And the ball lost at a crucial time. Preston, patiently building up. And the goalkeeper, it's his ball. A quiet moment here. Let's go to Alan McAnally, who's got news of a goal in his game. Alan.
It's a goal for the home team. 31 minutes played. 1-0.
Great to have Alan McAnally out and about for us. And he's brought us right up to date again there. Keeper can deal with that. To bring them level. Up for grabs here. He's aimed for the far post here. Great goalkeeping. And they get it away.
I'm still thinking about that save, you know, Martin. I mean, what a stop from the keeper. He might just have won the match, you never know.
Strong piece of defending and clearing.
Shifted.
We just feel sorry for the keeper, really, the way he's hit that to his right. He's got no chance of getting a hand on it.
It is level. Both sides have scored here now. We've got two added minutes. Fox. So here we are at half time, and it's 1-1. Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well. He's certainly... Good action in the English League Cup in the first 45 minutes. Second half starts now.
Yeah, I think one or two players surprised us, actually, how well they played in that first half. They'll be delighted.
Yevaya. Chance to work it from the flanks. Preston. Taking on the opposition and the responsibility as well. In towards the near post. Saved by the keeper, but not decisively. Being challenged here. Stolen the ball in the attacking third too. A real chance to go in front. Very good stop here. Corner swung in. And the corner punched away. It's good play to get a foot in and intercept. The away team want to make a change. Here's Andre Simoes. Read the intentions. It's good attacking play, this, from them. Can he set himself now? Too close to the keeper in the end. Just a chance to check in here with Alan McAnally, who's at the Bolton game. And I believe, Alan, there's been a goal that you can tell us about.
It's a goal for Bolton Wanderers. 60 minutes played, 1-0.
And we're back here again, thanks to Alan McAnally. Massimo Luongo. Continue to knock the ball around, looking for the opening.
Really in the clear now, in on goal. Brilliant goal!
Well, what about this? Tiki-taka at its finest. I don't know how many passes they've had in the build-up to this goal, but it's a wonderful team effort.
Sheffield Wednesday with the lead.
There's going to be a substitution. It's for the away team. He's gone too early. He's offside. Andre Simoes.
Cleverly done. And the cross goes towards the far post.
Taking it on the fall to score.
Well, it's a fantastic strike. So spectacular.
What a strike that is.
Well, he could hardly miss that. From the right wing, that was a perfect delivery.
And they got their reward for it.
Brilliant entertainment. The scores are level again. Very tight affair here.
We've had a pair of car keys handed in at reception. A pair of car keys and a wallet. If those are your items, please collect them after the game.
Here's Andre Simoes. Levaya.
Well, I'm hearing that there has been a goal elsewhere, and Alan McAnally is the man on the spot. Alan.
It's a second goal for the visitors.
Penalty kick.
Oh, definitely. Who knows? We might look back on that as the match-winning moment.
Well, they've got the penalty. Actually, they probably want the player sent off the offender, but he's only got a yellow card.
I think he was a little bit relieved there, you know, looking at his face, but he'll take that yellow.
He's done the job, he's the specialist.
And that has got the goal from the penalty spot, well taken.
Well, he's got a certain technique with these penalties. Goalkeepers find it difficult to cope.
Well, there is an issue at fullback in this team, and you can see there's going to be a change now. And it's been a pretty tough match for the lad who's being replaced.
Well, his work rate, first and foremost, was not good enough. Didn't track back, let his man get away from him. Not good enough.
Forestieri.
Well, he's better than that. It's a poor pass.
Well, we had to break away from Alan McAnally there. Apologies for that. But I want to confirm for you, the visiting team have scored. They are winning 2-0.
Now they can swing into attack. And he's got some help.
Our man out and about, as always, is Alan McAnally. He's at the Bolton Wanderers game. And I believe you've got a goal to tell us about, Alan.
It's a goal for Cheltenham Town. 7 minutes remain. 1-1.
Top work, Alan. We're back here now with Alan Smith.
Set up to play on the break now.
Barry Bannon. Well, he has got a chance to get the cross in.
There's still danger here after this half clearance.
And the referee blows his whistle. The flag was up for offside.
That's
a dreadful error.
A timely challenge. But we're down to the last minute here. Andre Simoes. Marco Levaya. Here's Andre Simoes.
Five goals in a very fine game. And the referee calls a halt to it with 3-2, the final score.
Brilliant performance from this fella.
Well, so often we think of his creative abilities.
Continue to knock the ball around, looking for the opening.
Just a couple of questions. Thank you.
What a perfect day for football we've got here. Martin Tyler here to describe the action along with Alan Smith. Our football is from the EFL Championship in England against AEK Athens, against Charlton Athletic.
Yeah, real buzz around this ground. Full house, a lot of interest in it. Hope it doesn't disappoint.
So this is how the hosts line up today. We've got it down as a 4-3-3.
Yeah, it's a system that the Netherlands used to use all the time. I think really they invented it, and plenty of countries have adopted it since. If it works, it's really tough to handle.
Well, he could be the starter in this game.
Two goals in his previous match and two really good ones as well.
Free kick only from the referee. Nothing more sinister than that. Well, let's break away for a moment to go to Alan McAnally, who's got news of a goal in the game he's watching.
It's a goal for the home team. 7 minutes played, 1-0.
Well, right on the spot there for that story, Alan McAnally, of course. Here's Taylor. Here's Williams. Saved, not decisively. He's turned it on to the frame of the goal. Saved again. And this time it's a corner. Well, here comes the corner. Time to get the ball in. Defender did well to get to it, but hasn't really finished the job. He worked so hard on his heading, he needs to do a bit more work, I think.
Yeah, the keeper's waving that one.
What's the keeper doing here? Read the play well to intercept. Saw the goal and went for it. Great hands. We can hear about a goal in the Stoke City game. Alan McAnally will tell us all about it.
It's a goal for Derby County. 15 minutes played, 1-1.
Eagle eyes, as always, from Alan McAnally. Careless there. An opportunity here. There's some space to work the ball into.
Thank you.
Threads it through. Well, he's tried to chip the goalkeeper here. Pretty audacious.
Yeah, given the size of the keeper, that was an ambitious attempt there.
Saw the pass coming and got there first.
De Vaio.
Had a crack!
There's been a goal elsewhere. Alan McAnally's got news of that.
It's a second goal for the home team. 26 minutes played, 2-0.
And we're back here again, thanks to Alan McAnally. It's really passive play at the moment by the defending team. Well, he's better than that. It's a poor pass. Here's Taylor. Promising forward play from them again. Patient play as they try to get the goal. And the referee looks to his assistant, who's got the flag up. It's offside.
The hosts had more than enough of the ball today, but I am expecting to see a bit more from them in the remainder of this match. I think they do need to step it up to win it. Their strikers, the movement's not been as good as it normally is out there.
Here's the chance, and they put away the first goal of the game. So the first goal, it's 1-0. Here's Alan McAnally now to tell us about a goal in the Bristol City game. Alan.
It's a goal for Queen's Park Rangers. 39 minutes played. 1-1.
Thanks, Alan. Well, one pass away from being a great move. Marco Livaia.
Two minutes of added time.
I think the wide man's got a chance here. There's space out near the touchline. So it's 1-0 here as the half-time whistle goes. And we've got another 45 minutes to go. And set your watches, off we go. Very good challenge. News of a goal from elsewhere, Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for the home team. 48 minutes played, 2-0.
Thanks, Alan. Well, we'll follow that with interest. Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well. He's certainly been an influence on this first half.
Yeah, it was a good first 45 minutes from the lad. Got the ball rolling with that goal, and he's been central to most of the good things his team has done.
Into the attacking third. I think the cross is on. Well read at a key time for the team here. Marco Livaia. Good interception there. Lovely, incisive pass. Can't get the shot through. Good block. A couple of teammates up in support. He's got it away. Closing him down. Bit of space for him. Now out on the wing. Good tackle.
What about Charlton Athletic's next game?
They're playing Nottingham Forest in their next match in the Championship, and I can see them struggling in it, to be honest with you.
And they cut it out. Alan McAnally right on the button to tell us about a goal that's just happened elsewhere.
It's a third goal for the home team, 63 minutes played.
Guided through. Didn't connect cleanly, and it's a shame, really, because it was a decent shooting position.
It certainly was, and if he gets another chance, he's got to do better.
For Valencia, we've got some transfer information for you. It's a confirmed deal. This signing has gone through.
Yeah, I'm reading around.
Opening them up with a through pass. And the interception is a vital one. Apologies to Alan McAnally for actually intervening there. To confirm to you, the home team have scored. They are winning by 3-0. Well, now they can attack, and he's got support with it. It looked a certain goal until the defender managed to get some contact.
That's just instinct, but that is top defending.
Corner played into the middle.
not really away from the threat here.
In goes the cross. Well, it wasn't the most powerful header, so it was a very straightforward save.
Yeah, didn't quite get the timing in that header. It was a weak effort.
We want to check in quickly with Alan McAnally here, who's seen a goal in the Swansea City game. Alan, the details, please.
It's a goal for Preston North End. 75 minutes played, 2-1.
Eagle eyes, as always, from Alan McAnally.
We've got 10 minutes left on the clock. Cullen. Quick-witted and quick in his movement, too, to intercept there.
Here's a chance to whip it in.
Patient play from them.
Absolutely no trouble for the goalkeeper here. Cullen.
Darren Pratley.
Out to a wide man who's got room. They've shown him the inside and he's taken that opportunity.
Andre Simoes. There's only a minute to go. The manager's going to bring on a fresh player now.
The referee has chosen to add on two extra minutes. Here's Andre Simoes.
That's it, final whistle.
Well, the team that's won here have made the most.
Some questions regarding the match. No further questions, thank you.
Welcome everyone on a perfect night for football with the floodlights beaming down. I'm Derek Ray, joined here on the commentary box by Lee Dixon. And we're on the cusp of bringing you live action from one of the most exciting leagues in Europe, the Championship. It's Birmingham City and they face AEK Athens.
Thanks, Derek. Yeah, really looking forward to both teams producing entertaining football. Let's see if we get that.
Strength and control, a big part of his game. Well, he was just a fraction offside then.
That's all he needs to be, a fraction, and it was so close.
Here's the lineup for Birmingham City. Looks as though
the midfield will be flooded when they've got the ball. Defensively, those fullbacks will be asked to supply support to their three centre-backs, but it does enable you to play two strikers up front.
And news of a goal in one of the other matches. Over to Alan McInally.
It's a goal for the visitors. 7 minutes played, 1-0.
Cheers again, Alan. Well, they keep working away, looking for passing lanes. This is how the visitors will set up today. If you like wingers, you'll love this league.
Yeah, absolutely. I love to watch a winger play, especially with pace and power. The central striker will stay more or less in front of the goal. The support will be provided by the three central midfield players. The back four is pretty conventional, but the fullbacks will be asked to support from behind.
And Kieftan Belt has it. It's opening up for them. It's there for him. What a vital. And a goal it is, the opener in this game.
Well, keep it tight. That's what both managers would have been saying. But now the opening goal's gone in. Tactics have got to change.
1-0 then. Tremendously strong in the tackle. And news coming through from the riverside where there has been a goal. Let's find out all about it from Alan McInally.
It's a goal for Middlesbrough. 20 minutes played, 1-0.
Alan McInally with his finger on the pulse. And it's Jukic, Alvaro. A very good tackle. Andrei Simoš. Marco Livaja here. Andrei Simoš. Petros Mantalos. Can they convert? Still possibilities. Well, it looks so threatening, but the danger averted. Andrei Simoš. Is this the moment? Tenacious tackling, excellent defending there.
The hosts are struggling in terms of possession, but when they've had the ball, they keep delivering the sucker punch. A great advert for low possession, counter-attacking football. It's really working.
And it crossed the byline, a goal kick as a result. Well, I'm hearing there's been a goal in one of the other games. Alan McInally can fill us in.
It's a goal for the visitors. 32 minutes played. 1-1.
Many thanks, Alan. And Kieftan Belt has it. Showing patience as well. Real chance. Can't miss, surely. Oh, it's in. A two-goal cushion now. And the lead fully merited. Well, a second goal for them here. That's a lovely ball. He could pick out a teammate. Corner given. He's driven in the corner and punched away. Firing it in. An example of a goalkeeper in top form here. Andrei Simoš. Francis Amuzu. Kristicic. Petros Mantalos. Well, it was a very good looking move, but alas, no end product. And so it is, the first half story has been written. And I think it's fair to say that he's had happier days in front of... As anticipated, plenty of talking points so far. And now the second half is underway. Alvaro. And Kiefton Belt has it. Nenad Krstičić. Marco Livaja here. Petros Mantalos. A really sumptuous ball. That move looked as though it had genuine potential, but it's broken down. And he was in the right place to intercept. Intelligent threaded pass here. He takes aim. Unable to find the back of the net, and still a lot of work ahead of them here.
Well, he'd probably be surprised if he scored from there, but it is worth an effort.
And let's join Alan McInally, because I'm hearing there's been a goal on the Derby County game. Alan?
It's a second goal for Derby County. 53 minutes, please. 2-0.
Regular updates from Alan McInally along the way. Marco Livaja here. Now, plenty of live football coming your way right here on EA TV.
Well, that should be a really interesting matchup atmosphere. I'm sure we're going to get an absolute belter, Derek.
Give it away. They've regained possession. There has been so much speculation in terms of whether the transfer would go ahead, but it will go ahead, Lee.
Well, the fee is around £50 million, Derek. That's what I would pay for him. I think he's a really good player. I think he'll add real value to the club. The visitors' possession stats are brilliant, but it's just whether they can convert that possession into clear-cut chances. You sense they need to pick up the pace a little. Start utilising the wide areas more. The back line's doing a decent job. Hopefully the forwards can do that as well.
Well, just couldn't keep himself onside. Decided that now is the time to go to the bench. And that was a very fine read. We're now inside the final 20 minutes of the game. And a goal has gone in the Bristol City match. Alan McInally can give us the lowdown.
It's a goal for Bristol City. It's been scored by Andreas Weimann. A lovely swerving effort from the edge of the area that tickled the post as it went in. 72 minutes played, 2-1.
Cheers again, Alan. And providing width. Well, he's outplayed and outthought him. And the defender got the last touch. That'll be a corner. Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel change. And firing it into the area, and a goal here! Accuracy with the header, just what they needed. The ball rolling again in what has been an utterly one-sided match. Plenty of players waiting in the middle. A fine block. Colin. And Kiefton Belt has it. Alvaro. The cross is on. Well, clattered away. Petros Mantalos. Yorios Yakoumakis. An awful lot of green space to run into. And 5 minutes to go. And Kiefton Belt has it. And it's Jukcevic. Alvaro. Oh, that's a splendid piece of challenging. Oh, and a perfect ball now. How about this? And clears his lines. Fruitful looking attack. The keeper was never likely to be in trouble then.
The referee has indicated there will be a minimum of 2 minutes of added time.
Jonathan Grounds. That's it. The referee brings the action to an end. It's opening up for them.
We just wanted to ask you a couple of questions. No more questions, thank you. Thank you all for joining. We're now ready for questions. That's all we've got time for today, guys. Thank you.
Rich, we ain't poor no more. I ain't been back in a minute, that's crazy. I ain't seen you around.
Well, this is the kind of match every football fan looks forward to. A lot on the line and the likelihood of a tension-packed occasion. Stay tuned, we'll have all the action for you live here on EA TV. Well, most of the fans in attendance here have had to bring their umbrellas and wear their raincoats. It's a soggy day for this match. I'm Derek Ray, and joining me for commentary is the former Arsenal defender, Lee Dixon. And looking forward to bringing you the cut and thrust of the championship. It's AEK Athens up against Olympiakos.
Cheers, Derek. Yeah, really excited about this one. Looking forward to some entertaining end-to-end football.
Well, here is the lineup for the hosts today. This particular setup is becoming more and more in favour.
Yes, Derek, one central striker, two wingers who will provide the width, a very narrow three in midfield, a back four, the two full-backs will be expected to support, but also defend and help out the centre-backs.
Nenad Krstičić, Michalis Bakakis. It might be on for them. And the keeper would have been disappointed had he not dealt with it. And favouring power over subtlety, he's hit the woodwork, Lee.
Well, 8 yards to aim at. He's missed all eight of them.
And the defender finding a solution to the problem. On the ball, Georgios Masuras. El Abdelawi. Guilherme. Konstantinos Fortunis. A goal has been scored in the Huddersfield Town match. Alan McAnally with more. Are they going to forge ahead? Can they put it away? And crossed in the direction of the back post. Petros Mantalos. Racing forward, trying to catch them out. Well, not to be in terms of the counter-attack. It's with Leonardo Kutris. Space and time for the cross. Well, the clearance half-hearted. And a goal!
Let's have another look at this. He wasn't expecting the ball, but when it comes to him, he chooses early to volley it. What a finish.
1-0 then. Petros Mantalos. Well, they continue their push for the equaliser, but definitely not forcing it. And it's played into the centre. And it's gone behind for the corner. Played into the centre of the box. And putting his body on the line. Marius Oikonomu. He'll be breathing a sigh of relief. Ball one.
Well, Derek, they're not happy. Ref is taking the brunt of this.
Guilherme. It's with Leonardo Kutris. Spraying passes around, almost waiting for the opposition to make a mistake. Using space on the opposite flank now. And let's join Alan McAnally, because I hear there's been a goal in the Bristol City match. Alan.
It's a goal for Bristol City. 28 minutes played, 1-1.
Alan McAnally with his finger on the pulse. The pressure might be a chance here. Not much time to make up his mind. Now they've lost it. Origi. It's there for him. Almost unbelievably, he's kept it out.
Well, I'm not sure how he's reached that. Just look at the stretch on that. A brilliant save.
And he's fired over the corner. The keeper was up to the task.
Well, it's a decent effort, but it's a real opportunity goes begging there.
I believe there's been running towards goal. And the goal gaping at him. still alive. And the keeper has custody of the ball, but just a few seconds beforehand, he had a big save to make.
Well, keep hold of it. Have a breather, because that first save deserves us all to look at him and clap.
It's with Livaya, and attempting the through ball. And that, a piece of goalkeeping you're going to see again and again and again. He's driven in the corner, punched away, and very deftly cut out. It's with Omar El Abdelawi, given away.
The referee has indicated there will be a minimum of 2 minutes of added time.
It's with Livaya. Might still be able to do a bit of damage. Well, somehow the... And with that, the first half draws to a close. As anticipated, plenty of talking points so far, and now the second half is underway. And on the ball, Valbuena. Valbuena. Patrice on the ball. Valbuena. Well, they would have been in a decent position there, but offside.
Oh, what a wasted opportunity that is.
I'm hearing there's been a goal in the Charlton game. Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for Charlton Athletic. 50 minutes, please. 2-0.
Regular updates from Alan McAnally along the way. Well, pass after pass, maybe they can chisel an opportunity. And offside is the decision. It must have been very closely.
Well, yeah, the linesman's got the best view of them all. I think he got that right.
I think most fans would be pretty happy with this man's display so far.
Well, Derek, you're right. He has played well, and goals win games. He's been a joy to watch in this form. Sit back and enjoy him in the second half.
Surely! Staunch rearguard action. The drama of the Carabao Cup. And it's live with us here on EA TV. It's AEK Athens facing Arsenal.
Well, a super atmosphere of cup football rarely lets you down. Exciting game that'll be, I'm sure, Derek.
I believe there's been a change to the scoreline in the Brentford match. Alan McAnally can tell us more.
It's a goal for Brentford. 59 minutes played, 2-1.
Many thanks, Alan. Marco Rivaya here. Andrei Simosh. And it's a quality pass. Nothing positive comes of it, unfortunately. It did look as though it was rather a fruitful avenue, but nothing doing. Well, a quick reminder, we have plenty of live football in store for you right here on EA TV.
Yeah, the fixtures come in thick and fast. Should be a good game, that. Well, hopefully that's not the commentator's curse.
Quick thinking to dispossess his opponent. Oh, a nice looking pass. Well, they get themselves level here, and they've done it to square the game once again. Exhilarating.
Well, here's the replay. You've got to ask questions about the back line and the goalkeeper. They're simply not there.
Well, the earlier goal cancelled out, one apiece. Let's get an update from Alan McAnally. There's been a goal in the Charlton match. Alan.
It's a third goal for Charlton Athletic. 72 minutes played. 3-1.
Alan McAnally with his finger on the pulse. Individual quality coming to the fore. Well, some news for you. It's a case of deal done. Alessio Romagnoli has completed his move to Spurs.
Well, the fee is around £50 million, Derek. That's what I would pay for him. I think he's a really good player. I think he'll add real value to the club.
And a throw-in it's going to be. They will now make use of the substitutes bench.
Nenad Krstičić. It's with Livaja.
Looking confident with the ball at his feet. Opportunity it is. Easy save. Let's join Alan McAnally. I say that because there's been a goal at Craven Cottage, Alan.
It's a goal for Fulham. 7 minutes remain. 1-1.
Thanks as ever for the 5 minutes left. And it crossed the touchline, so a throw in here. Well, they have elected to go to the bench at this stage of the game. And they're on the front foot, looking for a winner near the end of this game. Well, let's see about the cross. Keeper's contribution, but what next? Well, let's see what they have in store for them on the break.
Well, it's been a frustrating day for these fans. They want a goal. They're urging their team onto attack.
And dispossessed. And there goes the final whistle.
Just a couple of questions for you. No further questions.
This is the setting for our game for you today, the Emirates Stadium in North London. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith. Our football today comes from the Carabao Cup.
This looks like a really good game, Alan.
Yeah, a long way to go in this competition to get to the final, but good form here has a knock-on effect to a club's league campaign. And that's what the managers will be most concerned about, I think.
He's one I know Alan's keeping an eye on here.
Scored three in the last three. Another one here. We'll get out of three.
So Arsenal kicked off. This is the Arsenal lineup. Well, we think, Alan, it'll be a 4-5-1 formation, which can look a bit negative.
Yeah, but you look at the players in that five, that midfield five, and I think a couple at least will be trying to support the lone frontman.
And this is today's lineup for the visiting team. 4-3-3. And they've got natural wide players in that front three with a central striker.
I think that's the key, because those lads on the flanks it's quite a complicated job, actually, because they've got to come inside, support the centre forward, and they've also got to funnel back when they haven't got the ball. So an onus on them.
An update from the Etihad, from Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Stoke City. 7 minutes played, 1-0.
Great to have Alan McAnally out and about for us, and he's brought us right up to date again there. And they've got a man out wide. Well, now they've got the ball, what are they going to do with it? Flags up, offside.
Oh, I think he was half a yard on there. He's entitled to feel hard done by.
Marco Livaia. The build-up is patient.
He's missed the target by some distance in the end.
I'm hearing there has been a goal in one of the other games, and our man Alan McAnally can tell us more about it.
It's a goal for the home team. 16 minutes played, 1-1.
Thanks, Alan. To the other flank. It's good work, this, as they chase a go-ahead goal.
Burton. Burton.
Still passing, but not really making inroads. Trying to steer it through. Acute the angle, acute the degree of difficulty.
Yeah, it wasn't acute effort, that's for certain.
Let's join Alan McAnally now. News of a goal, I believe, in the Derby County match. Over to you, Alan.
It's a goal from Derby County. 29 minutes played, 1-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. It's good attacking play, this, from them. What an important interception that was. It's a good press from the team that have won the ball here.
The hosts had more than enough of the ball today, but they've not been themselves here today. We all came along expecting to see a win, and that might still happen, but just been a bit lethargic so far in the way that they've moved the ball.
It's a very good interception.
Burton.
There's been a goal in front of Alan McAnally at the Etihad Stadium, Alan.
It's a goal for Manchester City. 40 minutes played, 1-1.
Thanks, Alan. And the opposition will get a throw here because they've tried to play it into the wide areas. And couldn't find the player that they were trying to pick out. It was a good idea to try and use the width on the pitch, but it's gone out for a throw. And there's the interception.
The referee has indicated
the crowd maybe expected a bit more, but it's two added minutes.
Added time.
Arsenal couldn't keep it. So it's half-time and we're still waiting for that first goal. I just wonder whether the occasion... test this for the players in the second half and the referee as well, who might have a big decision to make. At the moment he says we can play on, but that might be in doubt as the second half wears on. In the Manchester City game, news of a goal, Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for Stoke City. 49 minutes played, 2-1.
That's Alan McAnally keeping us bang up to date. Chance for a break in numbers.
take note of this on... Well, they've got him behind here. Well, that stopped him in his tracks because he's given offside.
There was plenty of space in behind to run into as well.
Callum Chambers. Hector Berry. Bit of space for him. Now out on the wing. Can whip it in now. Berry. Trying to spot a potential ball to open them up. But they're keeping the ball well. Chambers. And it's in. An Arsenal goal. Marvellous goal here.
Well, coming in from the right, that was so inviting. Wonderful delivery.
Great ball, great goal. Arsenal have that goal. Foul called against Arsenal.
Well, the ref's given a foul here, and it's a bad one. Yellow.
Yeah, no surprise there at all.
That's a short one. And that's given away possession. Watching the Reading game for us today is Alan McAnally, and he's got an incisive pass. Can really get at the opposition here. He's got support in the centre.
It's Alan McAnally chipping in again for us. Great news for Reading fans in particular. And the score is 2-1.
Good interception there. Levi.
And now a throw-in.
Well, we're going to get substitutions from both camps now at the same time.
Andre Simoes.
What a good interception.
Let's go over to Alan McAnally quickly for news of a goal in the Derby County match.
It's a second goal for Derby County. 70 minutes played, 2-1.
That's Alan
guiding it through. Well, that was pressure for the goalkeeper from that through ball.
The big news today came from Naples, from Napoli, confirming their signing.
Yeah, and I think both parties will be absolutely delighted. I think he'll have a successful career at his new club, and around £45 million. I think that's money well spent.
Great ball. The ball glued to his boots, it seems. Excellent work. To get the equaliser. Excellent work from the keeper. That's a fine catch by the keeper.
Andre Simoes.
Now they can swing into attack, and he's got some help. And there's the cutback. In the end, good defending, really, put him off his shot.
Yeah, he did have to take it quickly, to be fair.
Well, the clock's showing 9 minutes left to play.
At Selhurst Park today with news of a goal is Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for Crystal Palace. 7 minutes remain. 2-2.
And we're back here again thanks to Alan McAnally.
Got in the way.
Arsenal about to make a change. The noise levels have gone up even more. And the scenario remains the same. The one goal lead. And we're into the last 10 minutes.
By the way, things are shaping up. It looks like the home team are going to see out this lead, but still a chance for things to change.
That's the referee's decision. 2 added minutes. But we're down to the last minute here. Loses possession. The referee has blown his whistle, and the game has ended 1-0.
So, beaten here.
Just a couple of questions for you.
Thanks for speaking to us.